blooper reel. Oh, man,
that's being dumbasses.
That's going to be like an hour-long video. Anyways, I'm Mike.
I'm John.
And this is
Generation War.
Yes. Yes, Zach and John did this originally.
Yeah. The pilot episode was originally supposed to be The Blob from 1958 versus The Blob from 1988?
Yep.
I think that's right.
Yep, somewhere around there.
Yeah. And we lost it all to corruption.
Right.
And not the fun Russian kind.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Or American kind.
No, yeah.
No, we lost it to digital corruption.
Yeah.
We still have, I think, half of it.
Okay.
Somewhere.
Okay.
It's somewhere out there.
Somewhere in the cloud?
Yeah. Okay. It's not in the cloud, but it's on some memory card that I have.
Oh, okay. All right. Yeah, but so what we do is we talk about the original, and then we talk about the remake, and then we see which is better.
We make them fight.
Yes. Yes, like Godzilla.
Yeah.
Godzilla and Kong. Yes.
That movie's never coming out.
Yeah, it's still scheduled for November.
Is it?
Yes.
I swear on the Godzilla fan page I saw that it got delayed again.
I don't know. I seen it this week. I see it's still there in that time slot, but
well, I'm not paying to watch it on streaming.
Nope. 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 Nope.
That's a giant waste.
Yep, wait for it to come out on Blu-ray.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Anyways. Yeah, so we got the awesome original Ju-on.
And the awesome The Grudge 2004. Michelle Geller.
Yeah.
That's right. Okay.
Yes. Yep. And then a couple of other actors that I recognize, but I don't remember their names.
Yeah. That lady from Veep.
Yep. Veep and Faculty and,
yeah.
And Carnival on HBO. Yeah. And yeah.
She does a lot of HBO
she
stuff.
She does.
Then, huh?
Yeah. 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 Wish I only knew her name. Shit.
You know. Sorry. A good show would have probably looked that up first.
You'll edit it in. It'll be edited in somewhere. Maybe at the end for credits.
Special thanks to...
Yeah, instead of Ice Cube this time, it could be her name.
I've only thanked Ice Cube once.
I know.
And now I have to thank him in this one again.
Good. He deserves our support.
So,
yes,
Ju-on, The Grudge.
Yep.
This is the third movie.
Yes, which I keep getting wrong.
This is the third movie, but this is a remake of this movie with elements of Ju-on, The Grudge 2, Ju-on, The Curse 2, and Ju-on, The Curse.
Yes.
So it's a weird amalgam of four movies all thrown into one, which might be why it doesn't work. As well as it probably should with the director it has.
Right.
Since
he directed all but two of them?
Yeah, Takashi Shimizu.
Yep.
He directed all of the Ju-on movies and short films except for Beginning of the End and The Final Curse.
Right. Right. Which you have seen, which I have not.
Including The Grudge 1 through 3 from America.
Yes.
He directed The Grudge 3.
Yeah. Which I have not seen.
Yeah.
Have you seen that, Jeff?
No.
No. I heard it's a great film. It's right up our repertoire.
I've
so.
Heard it's crap, but I don't know.
One of these days.
No, I will outright say that this is the director's cut.
Yeah.
This is the version of the film that we've had access to.
Right.
I'm assuming it's longer. Although it might not be. Who knows? Yep. I didn't do this research.
You can edit that shit in.
It kind of just occurred to me that this is the director's cut, yeah. And it might be different.
It might be. I mean, as much as I remember, I mean, I don't think it's that much different.
Like, from what I remember, I didn't see anything particularly different from what I remember. Although we both, last time we saw this movie was years ago.
That was a while ago.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
We could be wrong.
Could be, but probably not.
Like, I have a feeling most of it was just like, oh, we should make this bloodier.
Yeah,
or maybe the scene of the jaw on the ground wasn't originally in it.
Yeah, that could be.
Stuff like that.
Because that'd be closer to R than PG-13.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I don't remember the... This movie is rated R.
Yes. Yeah, that's rated R and this is 13.
Is it?
Yes. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, because I saw this when I turned 13. I saw it right after my birthday.
Well, then I guess it must have been, but why would they do that?
Because it's an American release. What do you expect?
I guess.
You want to market it towards everybody.
You market it towards the kids, and the kids are going to go see it.
Yeah, exactly.
PG-13 movies, historically, make a lot more money.
Yeah, they sure do.
And movies aren't art, they're products.
Yeah, sadly.
Yeah.
This one is more art, though.
This is.
Yeah.
This is a very cool movie.
It is.
You know what probably got added? Where a bunch of those scenes where Takeo, like, brutally murders...
Oh, that could be.
Kayako.
Yep.
Like, where he snaps her neck and all that.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, but, because I think that would get an R rating.
Probably.
Yeah. And I'd imagine, too, I mean, I don't know for sure, but imagine, like, the longer scenes, the more drawn-on scenes. I would imagine that's
part of the director. Parts that linger on the scares a little bit more.
Yeah.
Mm.
Yeah.
Maybe that's... that's a lot of the issue I have with this movie.
Yeah, that's the problem with it. Yeah, absolutely.
So, Mike, tell us a little bit about Ju-on, the Grudge.
All right, I'll read it. All right. An eerie tale of a family who is brutally killed in their own home, leaving behind an evil spirit lurking in the shadows. When an unknowing home care worker enters, the spirit is awakened and a terrifying chain of events begins, passing through all those who step foot in the dark house. And so, just a lot of crazy, cool shit happens in the house. I mean, it's subtle, eerie horror, where you can just all of a sudden see in the shadows, oh, there's Toshio.
Oh. Yeah.
Yep, and there's all sorts of Kayako, and look in the ceiling. And
well, I feel like Kayako does a lot of, like, the heavy jump scares, and Toshio provides, like, the creepiness factors.
Right, right.
Toshio is always kind of, like, there in the background. He gets reflected in, like, mirrors or things when you don't see him.
Or there's, like, a really sharp cut, and there he is.
Yeah.
Which we had to rewind it a couple times. I'm like, oh, that was there?
Yeah.
Because it's really quick.
Yeah.
It is. It's quick.
He does, like, he's the background ghost in the Mike Flanagan movies.
Yeah.
And Kayako is...
Yeah, she's Nell. The star. Yeah.
And she's the one screaming in people's faces and stuff.
Yeah.
It really feels that way. Kayako is a much more hostile presence than Toshio, even though it's very well established that Toshio kills people.
Yeah.
So Toshio is... more, oh, look at me, I'm an innocent kid, and lures them in.
Right, yeah.
And Kayako is a hunter.
Yes, yeah. And I like this one because they have more of an ominous presence in terms of Kayako.
Yeah.
It has more of her, it has more of her backstory.
It does.
I think they have a lot more of her.
They have more of the ghost in this movie than they do in this one.
Yep.
Recently I had a conversation, and it was brought up that you shouldn't let your audience see too much of your big bad, because then they'll get used to it and it won't be as unsettling. But that's not really the case in this movie.
No.
And because I wonder why necessarily that is.
Why doesn't showing more of Kayako work? Is that what you're saying? Or it doesn't work?
Why doesn't showing less of Kayako work, based on that logic?
I think because Kayako is... It's just the creepiness of it. The way she walks. I mean, just the way she has her death rattle.
Yeah.
I mean, I think that the more of that, the better. I think that works perfectly. And that's where the American version slips, because you really... I mean, you're packing four movies into one. So, I mean, you're really not going to get the eeriness and the creepiness of Kayako.
I guess so. And, you know, I in my head, I would expect a lot more from a movie that packed all of the best scares from four different movies into one movie.
Yeah.
Oh, I say all of the best. My favorite one from Ju-on 2 is not in there. But we'll talk about that when we talk about Ju-on 2.
Yeah.
Because that movie is probably my favorite in the whole series.
Yeah. Yeah. And they have a lot of cool scenes in that.
That is such a good movie.
Yeah. Let's just say I can't look at a car the same way in terms of in the dark. No. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I think my favorite scare in this movie is the really subtle Toshio one with the guy in the wheelchair playing peekaboo.
Yeah, I didn't even see that one. We originally saw that. It's like, oh, look at that.
And it's so, like, uncomfortable the whole time. It's like he's the old man in the wheelchair just sitting there in the window.
Yeah, playing peekaboo.
Playing peekaboo with nothing because we don't see anything. And then, like, there's that guy who comes up to him, and he's just like, and he's like,
get out of here.
And then she's pushing him along, and the whole time he's just like, saying peekaboo at nothing.
At nothing.
And then as they're pushing him into the building, the door opens up. And he's right there in the door, and it's so creepy.
It is. Yeah, and I didn't even notice that.
Yeah.
I was like, oh, look at that.
Because some of the best things in this movie are all because of its subtlety.
Yes, and that works.
There aren't a lot of, like, strong music spikes. I've heard people describe this as a jump-scary movie, and I can't imagine... Well, anyone thinking that?
No,
like,
it's not even
you
close.
Must never have seen this movie.
No.
If you believe that.
No.
Because, like, there are a few jump scares, but I think they're kind of ingenious almost.
Yeah.
Because the biggest jump scare in the movie is cats meowing.
Yeah. And that's it.
And.
Yeah.
I don't know if it's intended this way, but through an American brain, it's ingenious because in our American minds, what's the most common false jump scare in any horror movie? It's always a cat jumping out of nowhere and meowing really loud.
Yeah, yeah.
And it's the biggest fake jump scare. And in this, it's not fake.
Right.
It means something's bad there.
Yeah, exactly. And especially when Toshio opens up his mouth and meows, it's like, ooh, ooh, ooh.
But no, this, we get another attic scene.
Yes.
This is the third, I think, Ju-on-related attic scene we've seen in Ju-on movies.
Yep.
Three out of four.
Yep.
So.
Yep.
And then we can also say, there's four out of five.
Yeah. Well, there's the attic scene too in the Ju-on Origins as well.
Yeah, I was talking about that one. Okay. I don't think there's one in Grudge 2020.
Oh, that crap.
I don't remember an attic scene. I could be wrong. It's very possible. I've been wrong many times on this show.
I personally don't remember that. That's a piece of shit that I try to forget.
I don't know, I feel like I enjoyed it more than other movies.
Grudge 2020? Compared to this?
I think so.
Oh my god, I think so.
Yeah, you think it's better?
I think so. I mean, it's a steaming pile, but I think it tries.
Yeah?
Yeah. Because it's something different.
Yeah.
Yep. It's a different take.
We get the classic stair scene. And you can put them in certain areas and it makes them not scary.
Right.
But, like, you take Kayako and you put her in the shower with you.
Yeah.
While you don't necessarily notice it. Or you take Toshio and you put him in, like, the empty space between a chest and the wall.
Right.
And that makes it scary.
Sure.
And he talked about how the entire idea behind this movie is the darkness inside of a home that you never see.
Yeah.
Including, he described it as... or he explained it in talking about traditional Japanese houses, where the farther into the house you go, towards the center, the darker it seems to be.
Right.
Like, actually visibly.
Right.
So, he said he took a lot of inspiration from that idea.
Right.
And just kind of
ran
with it.
Yeah.
And
he succeeded.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This is one of the best horror movies.
Yeah, it's up there. It's up there.
At least in pop culture.
Sure.
As far as pop culture horror movies go, right. This one's takes the cake. It beats out everything else.
You think so?
As far as popular
culture.
Right. As far as, well, let's say this. As far as big franchise horror movies, this one wins.
Alright.
Okay.
That's a bold opinion.
I think you could put this against Freddy. I think you could put it against Jason. I think you could put it against Michael Myers. They put it against Sadako.
Right, you did.
And they put Sadako against everything.
Yeah, pretty much.
If it exists, Sadako's fighting it at some point.
Yeah. What about Evil Dead?
I'm not ready to consider Evil Dead a big franchise yet, though.
Okay, alright.
I don't think I'm ready to.
Alright.
I still think it's a smaller horror franchise. I would say it's still more of a cult franchise.
Okay.
Than the Jason people.
Yeah.
Although, like, Evil Dead is definitely, it's amazing.
It is. It is. Especially if they're going to be creating more.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I'd say, we'll give it, a couple more movies.
Yeah.
And then we'll see where it's at.
Okay.
Because, I mean, if they make some more movies and they're crap, I don't care
anymore. Right.
And it doesn't have Bruce Campbell in it. They can still make it good without Bruce Campbell, but...
I know.
We have to see. And if Sam Raimi directs, which I think he said he is...
Okay. Alright.
And it's related, guys, because Sam Raimi...
Yes, of course. Yeah, Sam Raimi.
There's a commentary with Sam Raimi and... Scott Spiegel on this one, and then there's Sam Raimi produced this one.
Right.
But this one has the director commentary with Takashi Shimizu and Kakato Fuji. lady who plays Kayako in all of the movies up until Grudge 2.
Yep. Yep. Yeah, so that's 8 years of Grudge movies.
She plays Kayako in both of these movies.
Yes. Yep.
And the two previous installments of Ju-on that we talked about.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah. So that's very cool. We also get the same guy playing Takeo in both of these movies.
Yep.
So there's a lot of crossover in
there
this.
There is.
This movie claims to be more terrifying than The Ring on the back.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah. Because earlier we were talking about whether or not The Ring came first.
Well,
I don't know if that's true.
That's full of shit. give me a break.
So, in both of these movies, there's, they share a lot.
They do.
Of things.
A lot of things.
We get Bill Pullman playing Kobayashi from Ju-on the Curse's character.
Yes.
Well, I guess we can say Ju-on the Curse and Ju-on the Curse 2, since Ju-on the Curse 2 is literally just a recap.
Yep. Yeah. And then you got, what, half hour after that?
You got 45 minutes.
45 minutes.
Of the movie.
All right.
You get 45 minutes and 42 minutes and 33 minutes worth of a recap.
All right. Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah. A damn recap.
Yeah. The video I am editing right now. Oh, that one's going to be fun.
Yeah.
Hopefully.
Yeah. Yeah. Are you going to put out that half-hour recap just to start it? Just to be a smartass?
Just to put... Yeah, I'm just going to make the video like 2.5 hours long. And the entire first half of it is going to be the recap. And then there's going to be our video, which is about 17 minutes long. And then I'm just going to... Like, at the very end, I'm going to cut out all of the credits and everything, and I'm just going to combine the second half of Ju-on the Curse 2 onto the front of the entirety of Ju-on the Curse.
Perfect.
And just make it into one giant long movie.
That sounds great.
And that's what the next video is going to be.
Yep. So another 2.5 hour long video. You'll enjoy it. That sounds epic.
I might do that.
I don't know.
Just clip those two movies together and make one really long one.
Oh.
I bet that movie would watch really smoothly.
Yeah. It should.
I mean, it picks off
literally. It's
the Ju-on the Curse ends with her looking at the house and realizing that the woman inside has been possessed by Kayako.
Yep.
And then it just ends. Mm-hmm. With that scene.
Yep.
And the ending of the recap ends with her looking at that and then walking away.
Right.
It literally picks up seconds after the first one.
Yep.
Not even seconds. Yep. It's just like, it continues straight from the first one.
I don't even know why they would even make a second one. I mean, just continue it on.
Make a 2-hour direct-to-video movie.
Maybe
it originally was. And
I don't know, maybe.
Because maybe it was, and they were just like, we can't, it has to be this long.
Yeah.
And he's like, okay, well, what do we do? And they're like, release it as two, that's why it was, maybe that's why they were both released the same year.
Maybe. That very well could be. I don't know. Yeah, but I mean, it makes no sense to have a half-hour recap just for filler. I mean, literally. I like in this, in both these movies, I should say, you get the cool PSC elevator scene.
Missing jaw scare.
Oh, yeah.
Movie.
Yeah. I actually like that part.
Yeah.
I do.
I think.
It's creepy.
Well, this one was done 4 years later, I want to say. Because I think this is 2004.
Yep. And this is 2002, so it would be 2 years.
Yeah.
Yep.
So it was 4 years since they had already done that scare in You on the Curse.
Yes.
Which was creepy, but looked very bad.
Yeah.
Because CGI it's show. 2000 CGI. Yeah. It still looked better than Hollow Man.
Yeah, well, that doesn't take much. That doesn't take much at all.
Hey, guys, we're going to make a movie. What's it about? It's about Kevin Bacon raping people.
Yeah. Good idea, Kevin Bacon.
Yeah. Kevin Bacon, you want in on this?
Oh, yeah. Sure.
Definitely.
Sign me up.
I have no qualms about this movie.
None. None whatsoever. Dirtbag.
I'm sure Kevin Smith is... Or Kevin Smith.
Yes. Yes. Sorry, Kevin Smith.
I'm sure Kevin Bacon is a wonderful guy.
I bet he is.
I'm sure Kevin Smith is a wonderful guy, too. But
Him and Kira Sedgwick.
Yeah.
Keep making that bluegrass music. Keep us entertained during quarantine. Hey, he has a new movie out, too.
He has two new movies, doesn't he?
I don't know.
Didn't he have a Netflix one and,
Well, then that Netflix one, that one is...
I think you should leave. No, that's not right. You should leave.
Something like that. Something I don't remember.
I think we looked this up and I was wrong.
Oh.
Because I thought there were two different movies, but
I think it's just one.
It's just one. And then I was just like, yeah, definitely Kevin Bacon's in that one random Netflix movie.
Yeah, so hopefully it comes out on Prime or something.
Yeah.
Because he has a couple good ones. I mean, he has Stereo Echoes.
Everything I've heard about that new Kevin Bacon movie, it says that it is absolutely awful.
Oh, that's not surprising. I mean, if you want to watch a good Kevin Bacon, watch Friday the 13th.
If you want to watch a good Kevin Bacon movie, watch Hollow Man.
Yeah. No. No.
It's on Prime now.
Yeah. Yeah, great. Waste your time watching that.
Yeah, watch that. Yeah. It's only 2 hours.
Yeah. 2 hours of crap. Watch Stereo Echoes. That's a gem.
Yeah, I guess.
Yeah.
I don't remember if I've seen that
one. Oh, come on. That's one of the best. Oh, that's a great psychological horror.
Watch Tremors if you want to see.
Oh, yeah. Tremors?
Tremors is his best.
No. Friday. But it takes a
Friday.
Friday the 13th, man, when he takes it through the neck.
Friday, when he's like, damn. You know, Cube. That movie where Ice Cube and Kevin Bacon smoke weed together.
Yes. Instead of Chris Tucker, it's Kevin Bacon.
Oh, man.
Anyways.
I want an edit of that movie that way.
That would be fun, dude. Be so fucking awkward.
It would be so bad.
Yeah.
And it would be hilarious.
Yeah, I'd watch it.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. I'd pay to see that shit.
I'd buy that for $1.
Yeah. I'd take it out of the Walmart bid for a buck. Oh, classic.
So, this movie's a clusterfuck.
It's I don't like it. I think it was very dulled down.
Imagine this movie, but worse. Everything in Ju-on the Grudge is very well lighted.
Yep.
It uses a lot of white light.
Yep.
White and yellow light.
Yep.
Just very straightforward lighting, kind of like we do.
Yep. And it's grainy. It's gritty.
It's a little grainy.
Yep.
It's a little gritty.
Yep.
It feels a little dirty.
Yep.
You know what's weird about it, though?
What?
Is just... Well, not as much in this movie, but in the other movies when, like, the house is supposed to be abandoned and things.
Yeah.
How clean the house is. Mm-hmm. Like, in Ju-on Origins, they even make a point of it.
Right.
Where they're just like, should we leave our shoes on? And they're like, it looks very clean.
Yeah. But in this one, I mean, you kind of have that scene where she drops her noodles and... It's just a fucking pigsty there.
Well, like, it's like that when Rika first gets there.
That's a mess.
A mess.
Yeah.
But then we find out why later because of all of the. Because her Kazumi's husband gets possessed by to Kaio's spirit.
Yep.
And kills his wife.
Yes. Yep. Yeah, it's deep shit.
Which is a thing that happens in this movie, mm-hmm. but is not nearly as well implied or done or anything.
Mm.
It's not great.
Mm. No. It just feels so much cheaper. I mean, it goes for the jump scares.
It turns things that weren't jump scares into jump scares.
Right, it tries to do that. And all of a sudden you'll get like the big boom, and then you'll get like the scary music, you know, kind of warning you.
Yeah.
You know, here it comes, and it's like why do you need that?
You get spooky. You get your spooky music in this one, mm-hmm. but it's never like.
But what? Right. But once again, like it's that. Subtle.
Yeah.
It's not this over amplified.
Trying. Amplified the number of times we were just like, why is it so? Why is there just high pitched squealing?
Yes. It's coming, ringing.
Coming through the right. soundbar, and yep. it's because of the music in this movie.
Yes.
It's just. High-pitched
yeah.
audio squealing.
Yeah, and I don't know why that's needed, but I think I'm going to have to get a hearing aid now.
Well, you couldn't hear any of it.
No.
Yeah, because...
I couldn't hear shit. No. Thanks, rock music. Thanks.
Both of these movies we have... Oh, I know why I wrote that.
What's that?
So, I wanted to talk about this scene.
What scene?
Because it's so dumb.
What scene?
But it's the scene where, I can't remember if it's Bill... No, it's not Bill Pullman. It's, the other guy. The husband who kills his wife. Who
okay.
gets possessed by Takeo.
Yep.
And he's looking at an American newspaper, and it has baseball in the front of it, and he says...
Oh, yeah.
He goes, I sure do miss this.
Oh, I'm missing this.
Like, you miss baseball?
Yeah.
Or English?
Yeah, right?
Because baseball is the biggest sport in all of Japan.
Yes.
You're not missing baseball
no.
if you're in Japan.
Nope.
Trust me, it's
nope.
everywhere.
Yeah. Yeah, look at all the people coming over from, you know, Japan over to the United States for baseball.
Exactly.
I mean, Daisuke Matsuzaka, I mean, for the Boston Red Sox, I mean, he was their biggest prospect since Babe Ruth.
Yeah.
I mean, he was going to be absolutely dominant, but, you know, he got hurt. But I remember when he came over, it's like, holy shit, here comes the next superstar for years.
Yeah.
And you know what? You know, shit happens, but it still happens today.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you still get these prospects, and it's like, you don't know how good they're going to be, but... Man, but when they come over, is it sensationalized?
Yeah.
Yep. Hideki Matsui, too. Yep. Japanese Godzilla. Yeah, they say he may be good enough to go on. He may be the first Asian player to go in the Hall of Fame.
Really?
Oh, yeah. Huh. Oh, he was a beast. I hated the Yankees, but damn it.
Anyway.
Yeah, but I mean, come on. I mean...
Baseball is all over Japan.
Right.
It's
right.
a huge thing.
Yep.
We get the stair scenes.
Yeah.
In both movies.
I like that.
With Kayako going down the stairs.
Yep.
Just like we get it in Juon the Curse.
Yeah. Yep.
And I can't remember if it's in this one.
What's that?
In one of them. Or maybe that was in the alternate ending.
What's
this
that?
One. Or it's just like, we learn why, like, she crawls down the stairs like that.
Mm-hmm.
It's because, like, it showed when she was running away. Oh, it was in that one.
Yes.
It's yep. when she is running away from Takeo when he's gonna kill
yes.
her.
Yes. Yeah.
And she is crawling down the stairs like that.
Yep.
After she gets hit.
Yep. Yep. Yeah, so that one actually does something.
Yeah, that was... I mean, I can't necessarily say that this movie is... total trash and
no.
cash grab because
no.
it's made by the same director.
Right.
He was obviously trying to do something
right.
something with an American audience. Yeah. I feel like the movie loses everything it was.
Yeah. Because I think it's honestly because it's marketed towards an American audience compared to a Japanese audience.
I'm not, maybe like that's what part of it was, but a lot of the production in that movie was. Right. Maybe the producers had a hands-on effect on that.
Maybe.
But anyway.
Yeah, because it feels different. It truly feels different.
It feels boring.
Yep. Terribly boring.
There are several parts where I feel like, man, it sure would be cool if something happened right now, and it doesn't.
Nope. Well, that movie just, it keeps your interest throughout the whole thing.
Like, the whole time we're just like, there's a cool time thing in this movie, like there is in Juon Origins, and they kind of have a weird time thing in this one, but it's not actually a time thing.
No.
Because it's just Sarah Michelle Gellar is seeing all of the things that happened with Bill Pullman's character in the past.
Yeah.
In this movie, they full on do a weird time warp shit.
They did.
Which is amazing.
Yeah, I like that.
When Toyama is in the house and he's going to burn down the house.
Yep.
And he hears noises coming from upstairs.
Yep.
And he goes out and he sees his daughter, who is a child, as a teenager, running out of the house. Mm-hmm. And then all of her daughter's friends being killed by Kayako.
Yep.
Or disappeared or whatever.
Right. Yep.
This also ties into your least favorite part of this movie, though. Which, but basically the entire idea behind it is he's looking into the future and his daughter stops for a second and looks at him and they actually see each other. That is canon.
Right.
That they both see each other as there.
Yep. And what I don't like about it is she's crawling.
And then,
go ahead.
Well, because what happens after that is Nakagawa, who is mentioned in The Grudge 2020.
Yep.
That's the one big mention. It's the one big mention, the one thing that ties it as a sequel.
Yep.
Not a remake.
Nope. Not another remake of a remake of a remake.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, man, speaking of remakes, like, when we do Ring, it's... I think we're going to have to do a tournament with Ring remakes.
Yes. Yep.
There are, I think, four Ring movies.
Four, yes.
Four based on the Koji Suzuki novel.
Yep.
Yeah. Mm. Okay.
Yeah. So stick around for that.
Yeah. We're going to have to do like a tournament show for
That's going to be a good one.
Oh, that will be good.
That'll be a good one. So instead of the box set tournament, maybe we'll do that.
We won't do box set tournament. We'll do Ring tournament.
Yes. Yes. We've been waiting since January to get our second box
ring,
set tournament.
Ring, Kazanban, the Ring virus.
Yep.
Ring and the Ring.
Yep. No Ring.
And it said Ring.
Yep.
It's not supposed to be Ringu. He specifically picked an English title for the film.
Yep.
Or for the book.
Yep.
So it's supposed to be Ring.
Yes.
It's just translated that from Japanese because of the way Japanese is written.
Yep. Okay, so back to the scene.
Yes.
Yep.
But Nakagawa and his partner both run in there, and, like, at that point, Toyama is freaking out because Kayako's coming down the stairs, and Nakagawa and his partner, like, freak out, and Toyama just bolts, and Nakagawa and his partner both get killed by killed by Kayako.
Yes.
This is the last we see of Toyama.
Yeah, I don't get it.
And later on we see his spirit inside of the family shrine with his daughter Izumi after she gets killed by Kayako.
Yeah.
But we never see a death scene for him.
Nope.
And I looked it up because I was like, all right, I'm not seeing it on here. Maybe it explains it somewhere else. Maybe there's a short film we missed because they've done that before in the past.
Yep.
Nope, it's just never shown.
Yeah, I thought that was kind of shitty. It's like, come on.
All of the descriptions of the scene that I saw were, and then he dies.
Yeah. What the hell?
Or he eventually dies.
Yeah, it's like, come on. I just wanted to see some closure with that dude.
I don't know, maybe he dies of old age. Or he gets sick and dies.
Could be. Who knows? We don't know. No.
I'm going to say he had a long and happy life
died. I hope so.
At the age of like 50, I guess. Because he was dead by the time his daughter was a teenager.
I wonder if Marcus here has a spirit in the bag.
No, that's Toyama. yes.
His new name is Toyama.
Yeah, Toyama.
Yeah. Yeah. Yes. Okay. So, let's go on to the results. Let's go on to the boating.
Are we ready for the boating?
Are you?
I like the security camera scenes.
Oh, yeah, that's okay.
I like it in this one a lot better than in this one. It was really... Everything in this movie is very hammed up,
I think. Yeah, everything's big, boisterous.
Everything is in your face and everything.
Yeah, I like the security camera. That was cool.
Yeah, it's a iconic, memorable thing from the series.
Yep.
Just like the missing jaw. And the head, the hand in the head shower.
Yeah.
And the stairs.
Yep. I like the TV thing too, and. In the original Grudge, where there she's watching the TV and then the bass gets all distorted.
It's so cool, and the face gets distorted, and then the death rattle starts coming through the TV really loud, and then she looks under the blanket, and Kayako's there.
Yeah.
That's such a better scene than in this one.
It is, because the TVC doesn't exist in that.
We don't have, because I don't think there's almost any sound, like, music during that scene.
No.
It's just like... The weird sound of the death rattle coming through the TV and her, like, freaking out.
Yep.
And then she gets pulled and looks underneath and Kayako's there and she gets sucked into the blankets.
Yep.
And in that one, it's just really loud music. Hides under the blankets, and it looks at her from a bunch of different angles from of her being under the blanket.
Yeah, that's cool.
I hope that doesn't pick up on this audio. We have enough audio issues already.
If not, that's okay. This summer happens. Yeah, but I enjoyed the original.
I had fun watching both of them back to back.
Yeah.
It was very cool watching this one after we watched the other three.
Yep. Yeah. Well, they all tie in.
Yeah.
Yep.
How he actually took some from all of his movies and threw them together.
Yep.
I love how Sarah Michelle Gellar's only credit on the back of here is Buffy the Vampire
Slayer. Oh, yeah. Cruel Intentions was released by this point.
Yeah, I guess so.
Yeah.
That was a big movie.
That was a big movie.
Yeah. No, she's just a teenage TV idol.
Yeah, I guess
nothing
so.
Else.
I guess so. Scooby Doo.
Yeah. Oh, well, she was nice in Scooby Doo.
Yes, she was.
Yeah.
Yeah, she was in Scream 2? Or no, I Know What You Did Last Summer.
Yeah,
that was it.
Alright, so...
Ready to vote, Johnny?
I'm ready to vote.
Okay. Come on. It's not even...
It's this one.
Yeah. Shocker.
This is better.
Yes.
This is so much better. It's the original. The original wins this one.
It does. By a long shot, too.
I have to say it, so, yeah.
Yes, by a long shot.
This feels like a copy of that movie, but without the soul of this movie.
No.
It's like a zombie, I guess.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Or the whole time it's dry and I'm gonna say if you have a chance to buy this DVD for like $5, I'd say do it because it has Katasumi and 10-4s on it.
Yep.
Which is pretty cool.
Yeah. You get the short films.
And you get a commentary with Takashi Shimizu and the actress who plays Kayako.
Yep.
And that's probably really cool.
Yeah. Yeah, $5.
Yeah, $5. Actually, I think I got that one for $3.
Oh, then there
like,
you go.
At like a used, a used video game store.
Yeah. Yeah, then no more than $5.
Yeah. I think you can get it for $7 on Amazon, maybe, if you can still get this copy.
Yeah, search it up on eBay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Find it.
Yeah.
Yeah. I really like the idea of reviewing these DVDs. I'd say this is a good one because it has a lot of bonus features.
Sure.
And I was pretty happy with the bonus features that I saw. It has 15 deleted scenes with the filmmaker commentaries.
Nice.
Yeah. And this one, even though I think it's the only available English release of this movie, is pretty awesome because it, like, we went through the bonus features on this one.
Yep.
It's got a lot of cool shit.
Yep.
And apparently an English dub, too.
Yeah, I didn't know that.
I think I've watched it with the English dub, just like to put this movie on in the background.
Okay. Is it as bad as Origins?
Thanks for coming to visit me, Mariko. Guess I'll go get some caffeine for me and you.
Dub of a Japanese film.
Right. Which is a 2.0 audio.
Yeah.
Compared to a 5.1 Dolby.
Kazumi? Wake up. Kazumi? What is it? What's wrong with you? Look at me, Kazumi!
It's shit.
Yeah, I imagine.
I don't understand how movie dubs work, I guess. There are a lot of really good anime dubs lately.
Okay.
They have not been as successful with film.
Okay. Alright.
It's a very different kind of voice acting, but...
Okay.
You know, you'd think that we could find someone who's not a robot.
I don't know. I have no idea. Because I know I tried to watch the German show Dark on Netflix in English, and it was just as bad as Ju-on Holiday. I said, oh my god, I can't take this anymore. I got 10 minutes in, and I'm like, I just can't.
I watched all of Ju-on Origins with,
I'm sorry.
I even cut in some of the dub stuff into there.
Yeah.
I felt like it needed it. Yep. We need to share these things with people. Yep. We had a lot of issues with that Ju-on Origins video, but it's all sorted out, so go watch Ju-on Origins.
Yep. That's
it's
good stuff.
A pretty good video, if I do say so myself.
Yeah,
which I shouldn't, because it's fine.
It's alright. Gotta plug your own shit. It's alright.
Yeah. It has 7 views,
yeah.
I think. It's got more views than any of our other edited
videos.
It
does. It does. Yep.
And today, we just finished uploading The Beach House.
Yeah, gotta go watch
and
that.
And quality examining it.
Yeah, it's fun.
Yeah, it's a very... Very decent.
I like that movie.
I dislike it more after editing.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I'm sorry. It's the opposite issue that I had with Ju-on the Curse 2.
Oh.
Is where I liked that one more after I finished editing. I disliked The Beach House more and more. Oh. I think it's just because as you're going through and you're like, all right, this is a good clip to use. When I was going through The Beach House, I was like, I need a clip of this.
Okay.
And I ended up having to cut. Like, after you see all of the clips are this, and then the rest of the movie is this, you're like, oh, that wasn't great.
Yeah, that sucks.
Yeah.
It's fun. It's a fun movie.
I'd say it's fine for a watch.
Yep.
I would say watch both of these movies.
Yeah. Yep.
If you don't have access to this one, watch this one and laugh at how bad acting was in the mid-2000s.
Yeah.
Not necessarily acting, but just how bad filmmaking was.
Yeah. Yeah.
Maybe not bad. It's dated.
Oh, yeah.
Not necessarily bad. Dated. Mm-hmm. That's the word for it.
Yeah.
This movie is very dated.
Yep.
Everything's very blue. Mm-hmm. Nowadays, we generally use, like, a bright bright yellows for horror movies. Yep. Yellows and blacks, and this was a time when we used more cool colors for horror. Yep. And at some point, we're probably going to get back to that point, but as of right now, we're very much in a different style. Mm-hmm.
Please, like, don't go back to it.
What we do now is a little bit closer to this, although I think this uses more white light than yellow light.
Okay. All right. I move this on that shit. I just know that the grittier the better in terms of a horror. You don't need that blue light that looks fake. It just looks fake.
Yeah.
It does.
I mean, it does that, and it darkens everything and makes it a little bit more difficult to see everything.
Exactly. Yeah, especially if you have glare on the TV. Oh, you're done. Just don't even bother.
Oh, you're still on that. Could not watch movie. Too much glare.
Yes. Sorry. Could not watch your film.
No. This one is not scarier than The Ring.
Nope.
And it is not scarier than Ju-on.
Nope.
It tries too much with jump scares.
It does.
And sucks.
Yep.
Because of it.
It does. Yep. Yeah, but Ju-on wins. The original. Cold clap. All right. Well, this has been
Generation Wars.
Yeah. First one.
Yeah. Episode one.
Actually, the second one, but the first one.
This is episode one. We're going to reshoot the second one at some point.
Yeah, all right.
Hopefully we can get Zach in on one of those.
I hope so. That'd be fun.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, put him against the sadness and something else just to fuck with him.
Dude, this is a remake of The Sadness. Like, what? Okay, we'll find, like, the longest movie we can find.
Yeah, like, I spit on your grave or I drink your blood or some shit like that. So just trash. Has he seen Father's Day?
No.
Oh, now that would be a perfect one.
At some point, we need to do those Clash of the Titans movies.
Oh, yeah.
Those will be fun for this.
Yeah. You know what we should do?
I think there could be a legitimate argument.
You know what I've been thinking about? We should do a trauma tournament.
We need to get some more trauma movies then.
Yeah, that's fine.
The lesser known trauma
absolutely.
Movies.
Absolutely. Hell yeah. Yeah. Hell yeah.
Trauma tournament.
That'd be fun.
Yeah, that would be neat.
The ultimate B-movies. So, that'd be fun.
Do a full moon tournament.
Oh, yeah. That too. Yeah.
They just had a movie. I think it starred the Tiger King.
Oh, my God. Well, you can count me out on watching that shit. Anyways, Ju-on wins.
Ju-on wins.
Yeah.
Ju-on the Grudge, everybody.
Yes.
The third in the series.
Yes.
Watch all of them.
Yep. Don't
great.
Forget about it.
Yeah.
First one and two.
All right.
Yeah. All right. I'm Mike.
I'm John. Bye.
Take care. Wear a mask.